3, 2, 1.
Yo, yo, yo. Welcome to Legal Aliens Podcast. I'm Joey Villagomez.
I'm Abi Sanchez.
Welcome, welcome. It's happy Veterans Day, man.
Shout out to the vets. I know we got some comics that are vets. We got Kelly Howard.
Kelly Howard's a vet?
She was in the Air Force. Mark Simmons, I know.
Mark Simmons.
Shit, Brian Morton was in
there. Alex Ortiz, Brian Morton.
Yeah.
Rovon Hill.
John McCombs.
Jamal Guishan. How do you say that?
Yeah, that dude was having babies all over the world.
Shout out.
If you don't know who Jamal Guishan is, follow us. Go watch a show of his. That motherfucker got babies.
That motherfucker got baby mamas at the... He had baby mamas at the fucking military base outside yelling, "You better come out, you motherfucker."
Like all them protesters out there, like, "Nah, they're just my baby mamas." Like,
yeah, they thought they were protesters.
They ain't like, protesters. Baby mamas. Shit.
Motherfucker, you better come out and take your kid.
My bad, Jamal. I don't mean to put all your business out there. My bad, bro.
If he listens to this, man, we giving you a shout out, man.
Shout out to any listeners. I know we got Moises.
Hey, straight up Moises Garcia. Loudest motherfucker on earth.
Shout
out to Moises, man. I mean, that motherfucker was in combat too, man.
Hell yeah, he's a combat vet.
Hell yeah, shout out to my homie Mario Perez.
Yeah,
young Gotti from back in the hood.
And then
went to Afghanistan.
Did you ever
after 9/11 happened?
You ever think about going to the army, military?
Hell no.
Did you get the recruiters coming to your house?
Not really, bro.
No. So
I don't know why, bro. I think they thought we were just little motherfuckers.
I feel like they slowed down because.
But I'm thinking even back in the day, like in the 90s. They didn't really come to your house like that.
No, they did me.
They did, not
bro,
to
we went, so what we would do is, you know, when did you have to fill out the draft
school,
card when you were 18?
At school, they came to the school.
I know, but did you have to fill out the draft card when you were 18?
Nah, I don't remember. I don't know if I had to. I don't remember.
Because they still used to have, like, they wasn't implementing the draft, but we wanted to make sure you were over 18 male.
Just in case.
Right.
Man.
So I had to send that in. And the minute you send it in, they get your address. They know that you could be recruited.
No, because they didn't come to my house, man.
So what we used to do to my friends, we do each other, is that we'd fill it out and then send a recruiter to his house.
Right.
And the dude was like, "Man, you came over, took me out for cheeseburgers, and like, tried to get me to join the Marines. One time a dude came to my house and I looked like, because I could see through the door, like the glass, I was like, "Ah, fuck, the motherfucker's in a uniform." So I go down, open the door. He's like, "Hey, he's like, is Abi Sanchez there?" I was like, "Nah, man, he's not here." And he's like, "Oh, okay. Well, can you tell him to stop by?" And he's like, "I'm like, yeah." He's like, "How old are you?" And I'm like, "I'm fucking 19 at the time." I'm like, "Oh, man, I'm only 15 years old, bro."
Oh, damn.
I got a full fucking beard. I got a beard like I do now. Just
deep ass voice. Nah,
just
man,
like,
I'm
nah,
straight.
Dog. Like, I'm only 15. Straight, he's man. Like, "You look kind of old." I'm like, "I got."
You look like you could hold an AK-47.
Yeah, I eat a lot of Burger King chicken sandwiches. I got GMOs in me. Like, fucking,
that's wild, man. Cause like,
they would come to the house. It was hilarious.
It is crazy how they do recruit in the hood. Cause like, you know, like Fiesta del Sol.
Yeah.
Like when you go to those hood festivals and Pilsen,
oh, there's always
have a big ass army booth.
Yeah.
Cause they know like half the kids walking through there are involved with gangs.
Right.
Don't really have both parents at the crib.
And there's an option.
So you know,
it's a legit option.
And then it's right next to Benito Juarez High School, where some, you know, back in the day was kind of violent. So yeah, they're walking past that booth like, go back to that fucked up school,
but what's
or
crazy
go to the
is,
military, and they get kids like that's fucked up.
What's crazy is they're recruiting people with like that might have PTSD.
PTSD,
and then they go into it, and then they get the PTSD even worse when they come back. Like it's fucking crazy, man.
But they get you with the whole pay for your college. You can turn it into a career, but you still got a motherfucker yelling in your face. You got to be disciplined. These motherfuckers. That's one thing where it might help. Whereas a lot of these motherfuckers are just not disciplined.
Well, they need
bro.
A discipline. Yeah.
Or somebody, a routine.
There's probably
you know
way
like
more
a daily routine.
I know a lot of people that this shit just definitely fucking helped, and they just better people now.
They're just better people.
Right. They hit them with that discipline. Like, oh, that's what I was missing in my life. Motherfucker telling me what to do.
Motherfucker telling me what to do, yelling at me.
Me figuring shit out on my own.
Fucking Full Metal Jacket style straight in your face. You fucking pile of shit.
Man, I could relate to Gomer Pyle.
I like, hey, man, I love.
Gomer Pyle was like, that's all we had as
Gomer
a fat
Pyle
kid. Like, we just
from
had
fucking Andy Griffith?
No, Gomer Pyle. Oh, from.
I thought the
name.
Real Gomer Pyle.
No, that was his name, Pyle.
Yeah, Private Pyle.
Private Pyle. Dude, as a fat kid, I relate to that guy. Like, I was like, fuck, man. Right.
I like Gomer. I was going like to say, damn, you weren't goofy like Gomer Pyle, motherfucker, from Andy Griffith. You remember his career?
Sorry, Mr. Osler.
You were goofy like that?
Nah, I was one of them fucking dark, fat motherfuckers like Pyle. Like,
oh, shit.
Fucking
like, hey. Looking at that motherfucker like that.
Hey, Sarge.
Dude, that movie, man, I remember when I saw that shit.
I only used to
I was young, bro, when that scene. You like Full Metal Jacket?
Hell yeah, dude.
when that scene came out, when he was in the bathroom, when he fucking killed himself.
I, honestly, whenever I watch that movie, I kind of just stop it right there. Because it's a big chunk of the movie.
That's, and the,
I
don't, that's the traumatic part where you wait for that part. Like,
I feel like that's the
God
most.
Damn, yeah. I got through that. That was wild.
Because then the rest of the movie, I've seen it. I just can't tell you other parts and like, hey, me love you long time. And fucking, you want sucky sucky and shit like
hell
that.
Hell yeah.
And like this pure Alabama.
Just the funny
black
shit.
Snake.
Yeah, exactly, bro.
So there's,
but you know, like Army movies, man, like.
There used to be a ton of Vietnam movies, bro. Like fucking Platoon, Apocalypse Now,
Hamburger
like
Hill. You ever see Hamburger Hill?
Yeah, that one, that's that another one. And then
but they're all Vietnam movies.
Fucking, it was crazy that I wonder if it's because they can't really verify those stories happened. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Like it ain't like, because they can make the shit up.
They
it
can
ain't
make
like,
the shit up.
Like Iraq. They don't. They make movies about that, but it's like Hurt Locker, where it's like more about the person, American Sniper.
I think the
shit.
First, like the first Iraq movie they made was with Three Kings, wasn't it?
We Three Kings.
That was decent.
I like that.
That
movie.
Was that was
when the fucking
good.
Bullet ends, like, it sets in,
and it fucking shatters the bone and all that.
Yeah,
it?
And then this fucking. How much of that gold do you think you can get out of there? Like, shit, would you have been that greedy and try to take all of it?
No, I mean, I'm gonna take a block at least. Shit, like no, like take, a souvenir. I mean, like I'm gonna
I'll
take
probably,
a block of Iraqi gold.
I'll take like two bags. Two solid like duffel bags.
I'll just make one big ass chain, like one big Mr. T chain. Shout out to much, Eric and Nicole Clark. Like one big rope chain. That's yeah. good.
How much are them bricks? Like,
aren't they heavy as fuck?
They're like 5 pounds?
Yeah, they're very heavy.
Yeah, you're not going to be able to just carry it like that.
No,
bro.
No, no. That's why they had the whole system set up where they had the whole people trying to get the shit out of the the cave.
Yeah, yeah.
And he's like, we're confiscating this for you.
So one brick is 24.7 pounds.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. God
damn.
Damn.
And it's in a duffel bag?
That's a lot, yeah.
And you think about
yeah,
how
so
much
you got
is,
four
like,
of the motherfuckers, holy shit.
And
yeah.
gold's like 15 an ounce,
yeah.
1500 an ounce or some shit like that.
Damn, so one of those bitches is, bam.
You ever watch them like mining Alaska shows where they're just digging up, like hunting for gold? And when they get it, it's just like a powder. And it's like, oh, here's a, you get like 6 ounces of gold. And
oh, shit, yeah, yeah, because it's
10,
just
10,000, but they tore up the fucking earth
dust.
For it. I'm like,
just for that shit, that's fucked up, bro.
We got to stop, we got to find alternative.
That's
to
why,
gold.
Like, like I like movies like that too. Like Blood Diamond was dope. You know, like fucked up ass movies, man,
yeah.
where they show you about like motherfuckers losing their arms and shit like that. Like, what's your favorite war movie?
My favorite war movie?
Yeah, mine Forrest is still Gump. Fucking. Mine is still Saving Private Ryan, man.
Saving Private Ryan, that is hands down one of the best war movies.
That movie right there. Here's the reason why it blew my fucking mind. It came out like in what, 97?
Yeah.
I forgot what other movie we were gonna go. Me and my homies, like we were with my boys. And we're like smoking weed and shit. And we were going to go watch another like a cool, I think like Matrix or some shit.
Yeah.
Like Matrix 2. Something good. But that shit was sold out. And my friend Mario, the dude that went to Afghanistan, he was like, that fool's always been obsessed with like army and shit. Let's go watch Saving Private Ryan. And all of us were like, nah, that shit looks boring, man. You know, from the commercial.
Yeah, because they don't show that for that Normandy
that
shit.
That fucking first scene, bro. We're all in there blunting, nigga. We were staring at that bitch like.
When that motherfucker was looking for his arm.
Holy fuck,
just like
bro.
Picking it up. And we're like, what the fuck?
Like, how did they get through that? Like, all that shit hitting the
and
fucking.
Then, and then when you're sitting on, when they were sitting on the beach and the God Germans are just like firing, like, you walked into an ambush, basically.
Yeah. But that's fuck. That's what's fucked up is like, that's how man. Much the. The U.S. is like
right.
the government. Just fucking send as many.
Yeah.
Fuck it. If the first 1,000 die, who gives a fuck? There's 10,000 behind them.
They don't. Yeah, they don't see numbers. It's a fucking. That's a video game like, back then.
Exactly,
the same
bro.
Thing. That's why that draft was so fucked up. Like, you hit 18, you gotta yep. go. Motherfuckers are running to Canada.
Fuck that.
My dad was wondering.
Where do you hide? Where do you hide? What do you do? You're gonna die. You're gonna be hungry, cold. You're just gonna die.
Yeah. You gotta be... you gotta be a fucking soldier to sign up to be a soldier.
Dude, I just remember, bro, that movie traumatized me, man. Like, I was already 18 when I saw it. I came out the movie theater like, God damn, bro.
Right.
I'll never go to war. And Mario was like, fuck that. We'll go, bro. We'll kill the enemy, bro.
That ain't...
Here's the thing, man. 9-11
no
happened.
Vietnamese ever
no bullshit. No bullshit. No shout out. Well, Saving Private Ryan was World War II.
I know, but that's but, like Muhammad Ali. That's why he
oh, yeah,
went to jail.
Yeah, true,
like,
it,
ain't no Vietnamese ever did nothing.
None
no,
me.
I got enemies here.
But that was an occupation, though. At least the German was, we had to stop Hitler. At least there was a,
there
like,
was
a purpose to that motherfucker.
Yeah, yeah.
But the thing about fucking, about Mario, my boy Mario, was 9-11 happened, right? And I remember I came home, like, right after the fucking towers dropped and everything, came home from work. So I went back to the hood. So it's just a bunch of thugs, sad, bro. Like, everybody was in the hood, just sad, dude. Like,
yeah.
Fuck, dude. We just, and Mario was like, that's fucked up. He got all fucking anti-Muslim real quick.
Bro,
so then we went to the liquor store, and like the Muslims that work in there, like the black dudes were fucking with them. Like, damn, Solomon, y'all motherfuckers, wow, bro. You know, like.
That's
dude, I swear to God, they were whole, clowning, yo.
Bro, the whole country got anti-Muslim. Yep. You know why? Because that's when bacon sales took the fuck
off. They took the fuck off.
Everything started having bacon in it. You like, anything you think you could enjoy, like put a fuck milkshake, bacon.
Hummus had motherfucking
hummus had the bacon dips. It was fucking like.
They were putting lard in hummus.
I honestly don't remember bacon that being that big of a part of my life growing up as it is like wild, once man. I hit my 30s and shit that shit was like yeah, bacon on everything.
A fucking a year later, you know, like when George Bush started the war, this motherfucker went and signed up, dude. Like, I gotta get out the hood, bro, because that's these dudes were banging too. They were gang banging
right
hard,
I mean
bro.
But that's I like
and
I said,
he just got shot in 98
yeah
in front of my house.
That's a fucking viable option, man. I mean,
he dipped, but they bad, but he came back fucked up. Like, you don't come to the city, bro. He like he thinks they're gonna kill him. He stays out in the suburbs, bro. He don't, Mario don't come to the city for shit. And his dad still lives on the block.
Shit, I think Anthony
Fuentes got that. Fuck that. He don't come around, bro. He's just a different dude, man. Like he's real like quiet and shit. But dude's wild, man.
That's crazy.
I got more stories that I can't tell on the podcast about that motherfucker. It's a wild motherfucker.
Shout out
yo.
To anybody that signed up for any armed service.
Yeah, man, because you don't come back right from that
That's
shit,
not a sacrifice I would ever make, so that's strong shit.
Even, I mean, I don't know, man. When I even think about, like, the draft, like, you know how you talk about taking yourself out when the world ends?
Yeah.
Like, if we had to go through a draft, like, they're going to come grab me and take me to war, like, I think I'll take myself out from that shit.
No, my dad straight up got a letter in the mail.
Fuck that.
Thinking that he was getting drafted to go to Vietnam, and this motherfucker just started packing his bag ready to go to Canada. And then he looked at it, it was like, it was my uncle. He's like, oh, okay, cool. Then,
like, that's fucked up. And he didn't even warn your uncle. They just came and snatched him up.
And then my uncle, yeah, he's like, hey, man, oh, I got this letter 10 days ago. But my uncle went over to Vietnam, and he came back, and he was like, he was cool, though. Like, he was cool crazy.
That's wild, man.
My uncle Charlie.
That's fucked up. He didn't even warn him, like, hey, man. They're coming to get you. He just threw it with the rest of the mail. Your uncle's in his fucking underwear eating cereal and shit. These motherfuckers show up. Pop, pop, pop. Let's go. You going to war.
He's fucking just doodling on the back and shit. Like, oh, fuck. Hell here you go, man. Just like,
man, that's scary, though, man. Like, fuck that, hell bro. Yeah. Like, to be like a kid, bro. 18, you're still a kid, man.
I got drafted. Like,
they send you to a boot camp with a bunch of strangers and shit. Like, fuck that.
Like, I'd be like Donald Trump, man. I got bone
spurs.
Baby,
shout
bro.
Out to the hell yeah.
My family's rich. I got bone spurs. I can't.
I got hemorrhoids, man. I can't run. I got diaper rash and hemorrhoids, man. I can't run.
I'd cut off my big toe, like, oh, shit.
Fuck yeah. I'll sacrifice a toe. Fucking just shoot it off. Just get a shotgun and blow three toes off. Oh, fuck. Do some fucking Evil Dead shit, like, just blow that motherfucker right off, man. But hey, man, that's better than fucking going to war, dog.
Hell yeah. I'll get
fucking man. Shout out to the veterans, man. You
for
did
real.
It.
Y'all did that shit.
Shout out, man.
What else happened? Oh shit. Oh. Club Dub opened up again.
Oh
the
man.
Bears got a victory. Club Dub had turned into like one of them Halloween spirit stores for a little while. They got abandoned. Halloween spirit sold some shit out of there, and then they came back November. Boom. Fucking first weekend of November, right? Is that
yeah,
what it
dude.
Is? No, it's
no,
not.
That's second.
No, second.
The thing about Club Dub is, do you think they should be doing it?
No.
No. I don't either, man.
You beat the fucking Detroit Lions with a backup
Jackson,
quarterback.
Yeah, barely beat these motherfuckers. He even threw more yards than Trubisky.
I like that Driscoll kid. He looked like he gets
sure, we should bring his ass over.
I know. Can we trade, like, mid-game, just trade Driscoll for Trubisky and see what happens?
The fucking Lions ain't got nothing to lose, dog.
I feel like that's why nobody... I think if you know you're out of it, at a certain point in the NFL, stop punting. Like, it's fourth and whatever. Just fucking go for it.
Just
like,
go for it, dude.
If you're both out of it, you're both... Like,
yeah,
Bears
but the
can't
thing
get
is,
any
man,
more draft picks. So just fucking always go for it. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, but it all depends. I mean, you still got to punt, though, bro. Cause
nah,
I mean,
fuck
who,
that shit, bro.
You think, like, if it's over?
Like, if your season's done, right? You're fucking... You're out of
the
playoffs.
Yeah, but still, you don't want to just get blown out in every
nah,
game,
but
man.
I'm saying you still try. But, like, just go for it on fourth down. If you
yeah,
pass the, if you had the 40
but if you got
line,
a good defense, you still got to try to stop these motherfuckers.
That's
put
what I'm
it
saying.
Off,
like,
man.
I put, I'm like, I want to see who's who. There's
yeah,
a,
but you're
there's
gonna
a dude. There's a dude.
You're gonna risk it and put Aaron Rodgers fucking close as hell to the end zone.
Step up, D.
Hell nah.
But like, okay,
that.
If you
you'll be
fucking,
losing a lot of
you
games,
at,
man.
Okay, you're at your 40 yard line, and it's like fourth and five. Just go for it. Fuck it. The season's over. You ain't gonna get no more draft picks.
See what you can do. 4-5 though.
I'm just saying.
I think you're taking a big ass risk.
There's this high school coach that he never punts. He never kicks field goals. He never punts. He's just like, fuck it.
And what's his record?
Huh? His record is usually undefeated.
He got a fucking Jim Boylan record.
He's undefeated. Like a lot of times, like they win state championships, and everyone gets pissed off at him because like they never punt, but they just like they fuck figure that. Their defense is good enough to stop the other team's defense, and if they get the offenses, he outweighed it. Like why give them the ball back?
Sounds like some Matt Nagy shit, bro.
I say it, but like why give the other team the ball? Fuck that shit, but
man. I don't know.
Take
man.
Take advantage.
Like the Bears, bro. Like I don't.
Let me.
I usually have faith. But the way they're playing, like, this season is done, bro. Because, you know, everybody's like, what if they win the next two? Because, you know, they got who they got next? They got the Rams, who suck right now.
Right.
They're struggling. And they got the Giants. Like, we could win two.
But you're hoping for
I think they got the Cowboys after that.
But then you're hoping for a wild card.
Yeah, but not only that, but at the same time, you're like, what the fuck they going to do in the playoffs? It's going to be worse
watch
than...
Watch them turn around and win, and then, like, this fucking, like, oh, shit.
I don't know, man. It's a mess, bro. Like, they didn't barely beat Detroit. Like if they would have whooped them, I would have been like, okay,
right,
something's happened.
Because that dude in the first Detroit in the first drive of the game, he got him down to
he
like
got
five.
Him all the way, bro. He drove it across the whole motherfucking field on him like twice.
That's what makes the 85 Bears so impressive, bro. The motherfuckers was like week 8 and they made a Super Bowl shuffle song. And they're like, yeah, you can't stop us, dude. Like,
and then Danny Trevathan, man, now he's out for the season.
Dude, his elbow was bent like this fucking microphone but the wrong way.
It was like this, but like
when he landed, that shit just curled underneath. I was like, oh my God.
Did you watch the Bears game?
Nah, didn't get a chance.
His fucking arm landed under the quarterback and twisted. You could just see the twist.
Yeah. Did it break for real?
At first, it looked like, but they said it just, his elbow twisted.
Was he out the whole game, the rest of that?
Yeah, he's out for the season. He's IR.
Shit.
But it probably tore his ligaments and his elbow came apart, man.
That sucks.
Like, his bone didn't break, but his elbow came apart.
He just walked off like, nope, something's not good.
He was walking off. He had that little concern on his face like, oh, yep. Shit. You can tell when the motherfucker be like, oh, like, come here, motherfucker.
Right. But that motherfucker just walked
like, who's the quarterback from the Redskins? Shit snapped in half.
RG3.
No. He had a tore his ACL.
Not Kirk Cousins.
The guy that they ended up getting.
Where he just
fucked. What's his name? Fucking Alex.
Smith,
right? Was it him, right?
But he came back. I don't know if it was him.
No, like a couple, like 2 years ago, his fucking leg snapped.
Oh, like
when he played for the Redskins. They sacked him and his fucking, this bone right here snapped in half.
Was that Joe Theismann? Remember that shit?
Yeah. And that thing is happening the same, kind of play or some shit like that.
When that fucking LT, and LT was like jumping on the ground like, oh shit, like he's like, come out. He saw the motherfucker's leg. He said that they said you could hear that
LT's
snap.
LT's a big motherfucker.
They said you could hear that snap in the stadium. Like, it was that, like, it was like, pa! It's like, oh, God shit. Damn. And then the LT was just like, oh, fuck. LT was on cocaine the whole time, bro. I'm surprised he didn't have heart attacks in the middle of the game.
Hell yeah, motherfucker
was
just
quick.
He was running through everybody, too, man. That's like, a big-ass one. Mm-hmm. Like, when they show his highlights.
Yeah.
Like, his shoulders, bro.
Oh, his shoulder pads?
They look like a bumper of a truck.
With that foam roller in the back.
Hey, is that raining outside? Yeah, right? You hear that?
No, it can't be rain. It's too cold for rain.
No, right?
No, that's a sink upstairs.
I was about to say.
No, it's too
cold. We've been having this shitty-ass weather, man. Turned winter on us quick, bro.
Dude.
That was fucked up, man.
Waking up, and it's like, damn, there's 2 inches of snow on the fucking ground.
Like, right now is when we need the teacher strike. the teacher strike when it's all nice out. Like, we don't need school buses on the road right now, bro.
Right. This is a school bus flipped over somewhere in Peoria. I seen that shit. It's just been
I saw that shit, too.
It's just crazy.
Like, what's fucked up is that... Like, I got up in the morning, right, early to drop my daughter off, like at 7 o'clock, and that shit was slippery, bro. Like,
she had to go to school today?
She go to work.
Oh.
My kids are old as fuck. Yeah, she went to work. Sure. So I fucking, coming out the alley, the whole back, I fishtailed.
Do it.
So that's what I was like, all right, chill, motherfucker. Like, this is the first frost.
Yeah, that's why I hate my
You gotta
car.
Get used to it, bro, because I'm fucking gunning it right now.
My car, the brakes, like, it fucking, fuck for some reason, my car just slide. I'm like, God damn. And fucking.
Are you about to hit something?
Yeah, it's like, I don't like that
shit. Man, that's why, like, the tire shops, I got a big ass screw. And I was about to do that, fix it earlier. Tire shop was busy as hell. All the body shops got cars galore just lined the fuck up. Cause, I mean, people make money off this shit. You know, people complain, but people got to make money. Auto shops are happy as hell, man.
Motherfuckers is
we got hit by a pizza delivery truck once. Me and my mom's, man. In a PT, we had a PT Cruiser. Car slides up behind us, smashes this whole side, the back of the bumper, like the
yeah,
the fucking driver's side.
Did you see it coming?
I saw him behind me. I'm like, mom, like, we're about to get hit. Mom. Bah!
Dude, I was.
It had foam in it. Just real quick, look, check it out. So I get out. I'm like, I'm going to call the cops, do a report. This dude's scared, dude. Like, nah, you know, no le hablas a la policía. Don't call the cops, whatever. He's from the pizza spot around the corner on 45th Street. So he's like, follow me to the pizza spot. We'll talk to my boss, whatever. He calls the boss.
Yeah.
Boss tells us to go over there and meet him. So we go in there to talk, and I tell dude, I'm like, look, we're going to need $500 for the fucking deductible, bro. We call it insurance. So we're going to at least need that shit.
Right.
He fucking grabs $500. He's counting it. His wife's all mad and shit. You're going to give him $500 right now? He's like, you know, like, what the fuck? We don't got insurance on the truck. And that paisa dude probably didn't even have papers, bro.
He's just driving
around. He's just out there driving around, delivering pizza, smashing into people.
There was one time I was on the expressway. Where I used to work, I used to go to a different site and then like had to come back to the other one. So I'm driving back and I had to slow down because the cars in front of me just started, it got backed up for whatever reason. Maybe it was a car stalled or some shit. So I'm sitting and like I slowed down and I look in the mirror and I just see a fucking truck coming. Like a straight truck, not a big ass.
Damn.
But this motherfucker was like coming. I'm like, ah, shit. So I fucking, I start to get out the lane and drive on the shoulder. I'm like, I'm going to avoid this dude. Like, he's going to hit the bike guy in front of me. He ain't hitting me.
Because you could see that shit happen.
Right, because I see him. I'm like, he's not going to stop. So I start to go. And he does the same move to try to avoid me. And he just clips up, like, my whole back taillight and all this other shit.
Oh, damn.
So we get out. And then we're talking, blah, blah, blah. And I had my work ID on me. He's like, you work there? You work at Berry Plastics? I'm like, yeah. He's like, that's where I'm going. He was coming. He was coming to fucking start, like, pick up a shipment right, from our company. So he's like, here's my insurance, blah, blah, blah. And then so I called my job. I was like, hey, man, I got hit by a truck. Blah. He's like, are you feeling all right? I'm like, damn, I should have said no because it was on work hours.
Man, dude.
But then
crack your neck in front of him and everything, man.
Now, they ended up paying for the repairs. I got a fucking... my rental was a Impala, the new one. Man, I was hoping that my car would take fucking months to fix.
Because you wanted to keep the Impala,
dude, that
right?
Impala was the smoothest shit I'd ever drove, man.
I hate when they do that shit. They gave us a fucking Buick, like a brand new Buick Regal, bro.
Oh, shit.
Man, I'm driving. That bitch was smooth, yo.
I'm like, telling you, that's why I was telling you earlier, like, I get a lot of phone calls. I spam phone calls because I be filling out them mall shits, man. Like, I'm trying to win a car. So every time I see a car at the mall, I just sign it up. Like, fucking, let me get this one.
Dude, you know what, man? I should start doing sweepstakes. Because I know a motherfucker that used to work at the city always mailing off sweepstakes, bro. Because I used to run the mail machine.
Did he ever win?
I don't know, but he mailed off a lot of those motherfuckers. A dude named Tony.
Dude, the fuck.
He always be like, hey, can you throw his mail in there? Because I used to stamp people's mail. Personal mail, too.
I would fucking love when I get the publisher clearinghouse. Like, oh, I'm going to see what magazines I can order. Like, I win this fucking fan. I want these people to show up at my house.
You still play lottery, bro?
Sometimes.
I don't play no more. It's weird because they don't do the drawings like they used to, man.
All the drawings are...
I don't believe that it's just all digital. Fucking, you don't know when it's going to happen. I mean, you know what time.
It's the same time. They do it on TV still, don't they?
Nah, they don't do none of that shit no more, bro.
Really?
The TV drawing? They don't do none of that shit, dude.
I thought Channel 9 did it.
I swear to God they still did that.
Channel 9?
I swear to God they
don't
do it
Channel 9
does
it towards the end of the show, end of the news, the 9 o'clock
news. I don't watch Channel 9 news, but I thought they cut that shit out. Now I got to look it up.
Damn, Pat Tomasugo mad as hell.
We got to look that shit up, because I swear to God.
But now you can, there's an app on your phone where you put money
in it. I got the app.
I got the app too, and I was like, all right.
I'd be scanning the motherfucking quick picks that I'd be buying and shit.
I don't understand why. If you scan it, it won't let you deposit the money. Because they...
Oh, like, yeah, it should, right? Like, if it, you should be able to link it to your bank account.
Right. And then
and
just void that fuck, and then void that card out somehow.
Oh, so they still do it, but they do it online. So they still shoot the footage, but they just don't show it on the news anymore.
They don't show it on the news anymore.
Oh, you got to go to the website?
WGN's website, yeah.
Yeah, they don't show it on TV no more.
I don't know. Why not? WGN shows fucking news.
You know how many Mexicans tuned in to watch that shit, bro?
That was our highest rated show.
For real.
Show. Was it a fucking
Mexicans
lottery?
I remember, bro, as a kid, if I was by my uncles, grandmas, at that time, somebody was like, put that shit on. I got to check out that.
Hell yeah. Or what we would do is we'd watch the 10 o'clock news, and then when it hit like 10:23, they would flash and we were like writing fucking the numbers down.
No,
like,
man, my mom and my dad used to want to watch the drawing, bro, the little balls and everything going
I used to like that too, but... it always like flashed at the 10 o'clock news, like, wow.
That's fucking hilarious. Like, tell you, Mexicans don't play, bro. We trying to hit that jackpot, man.
Hell yeah. Everybody trying
like,
to.
Like, put on the motherfucking lottery drawing.
I want to win that shit. I would love to win that.
Hey, man, all I know is that when you win, that shit feels good, bro. Because, like,
even if it's a dollar.
No, I've won $200 on a pick four at work, like on lunch.
Yeah.
Like, we'll go eat. I'll buy a pick four in the morning. We'll go eat lunch. I'll go to Scanner or whatever. $200 right there, dude. Like, cash it out. Motherfucker. I remember dude gave me, like, a bunch of fives and shit.
Every time I'm on the road, I'll buy scratch-off tickets from that state or whatever. Yep. So, like, Wisconsin, I think last time I was there, I won $100.
You can mail it in, too.
Michigan, they had the pull tabs. You ever play the pull tabs?
No.
Where it's just, like, a tiny little, like, cardboard card. And then you crack it and you pull the tabs over.
Shit.
And if you it's like a slot machine. So you got to match three cherries or whatever. In Michigan,
I was up there.
They got them in Michigan and Indiana a lot. So I crack them open. I'm looking like, oh, shit, cool. So I win $100 on one of the pull tabs. They were like, I think it's $1 each. So it's not. So I go to give in to the lady. And the lady looks like, oh, wow, big winner. I got to go to the front office for this.
Oh, shit, for real?
She goes to the front office to get my money. It's all in fives. Like, they were not prepared. It was like.
How much did you win, though?
I won $100.
Oh, shit. But they weren't prepared.
But they weren't prepared for someone like the big winner to come through because no one ever. You probably win $1 on that shit.
Well, see, that's why.
I was like, oh, shit.
I remember, like, when I would win. I won a couple $100 ones on scratch-offs.
Yeah.
And I go to somewhere where they're busy as fuck with lottery.
Like I hate the that. Fucking, when like motherfuckers the are waiting to play lottery, I'm just trying to get gas right now.
Dude,
like, I gotta wait for you.
Bro, no lie,
fucking
man.
Pick your numbers.
On 47th and fucking Western, bro, at the BP.
Yeah.
There's this old black guy rolls up in a Cadillac, and he just leans on the fucking counter, dog, with a list of numbers, bro.
They started making people
oh
fill out.
Oh, my God. Yeah, now they got to fill them out. So yeah. I don't know if he, you know, but he just stands there, man. 383, 55. Give me the $1 lucky shot.
That's what my mom.
4844. Like, bro, I was like, Jesus Christ.
My
bro.
Mom would be like,
I just want two numbers, dog. Quick picks.
Let me get a 6235 pick straight box 50-50. I'm like, what
yeah,
the fuck?
Add the
is
fireball.
This?
Add the fireball. they get complicated with that shit, man.
Dude,
there's times where I've missed the fireball will replace the number that I had. But I never
I
buy the
know
fucking.
I know what the fire like is.
Like, if you play 815, right?
Right.
And you play fireball.
Right.
For a dollar extra.
Okay.
814 comes out, but the fireball is the five. You can replace it and you win.
Oh, so you,
that
it just
fireball,
gives you an extra number.
It gives you an extra number to win.
Right, okay.
And there's times where I've played.
Yeah.
My grandpa's birthday, 831, and that fireball, I don't play the fireball, and the fucking fireball was the will replace the number I missed. That's happened a bunch of times, dude.
That sucks,
where I'm
bro.
Like, damn, if I would have just coughed up another dollar.
That's how they get you,
that
man.
That fireball would replace.
That's how they get you.
Yeah, true.
See,
I think they kind of know. I think they know who the fuck you are, bro. Like, all right, he never plays fireball. Add that fireball to his shit. Like, there's somebody monitoring that shit, man. They know who you are, bro.
Nah. There was a dude that figured out a system. I think he was in Texas, where he figured out where the deliveries were going to be of, like, the highest concentration of, where, like, he somehow got a hold of, like, which roles had the most winners in it.
All right.
So he would just go and buy like the whole fuck, like a whole thing of the roll, and he would just end up winning tons of money.
Just scanning.
And he figured
shit.
Out the system, like when the delivery date was and all this other shit, and he would just buy the whole fucking thing. And then he got caught and he had to pay all that money back because it was like, he's cheating. I'm like,
what?
He's not cheating.
No.
He just figured the shit
yeah,
out. Like,
you can't cheat. That's just being smart.
Yeah.
True.
Like that, see that documentary on about The Price is Right?
No, I haven't seen that
the
shit.
The dude that knew
it's
every,
on Netflix?
He knew every price. So every product he memorized. So he's like, okay, there's usually three options for each product, and this is what they're gonna use throughout the season.
Oh shit!
So he would fuck. He had a database that he would just fucking like fill in, and he had a computer
man, see,
program.
Motherfuckers get a little too technical with that.
And he
shit,
would
man.
Go. He would go to fucking.
He'd be winning cars and vacations.
Nah, see, he never got picked because you know Price is Right. You got to get picked.
All
right. So he never got picked, but what he would do is he would yell out the right price, and people would catch on. Like, oh, that guy knows. See, they would ask, and then he'd look at them, he's like, no. And then I pull, and then he won people tons of shit, bro. Like, vacations.
So do they hook
shit.
Him up, though?
Nah.
He's on vacation with strangers, with strangers and shit. Like, fuck it, they took me on vacation,
7-day cruise to Puerto Vallarta.
And they got to take this dude with
coach, they make sure they tell you. Like,
he's in every picture with these motherfuckers.
Just
no matter,
that.
Like, black family, Latino, whatever.
All,
just,
all four of them holding a long-ass alligator. Like, they ain't even a family member, just a dude.
Just a white dude and shit with the same clothes on in every picture, too. I don't know about, like all the algorithms and shit. You know what I'm talking about? Like, I mean, hey, don't get me wrong. I believe in that shit.
There's motherfuckers that figure
like,
it out.
I don't know. Like, I don't have the patience to.
I don't have the math skill to do it.
You got to have that fucking. You got to be like. Like have that fucking compulsive disorder shit.
That's low key. Like there's got to be like a spectrum.
Like sleight of a genius in your ass, bro.
Fucking autistic, where you can just focus
gotta
on one
Kanye,
thing.
You got to be some Kanye, a little Kanye. He's a genius. Genius Christian, billionaire Christian.
Christian. Billionaire Christian. Is he a billionaire?
No.
No, right?
No, there's no way.
All right, calm your ass down, Kanye. He ain't even a billionaire yet, bro.
I mean, his net worth is probably a lot because, I mean, that just means I want to know if he's what he's got liquid. I want to know what's in his bank account.
Kanye West's net worth... Oh shit! Between 240 million and a billion—that's too wide.
That's way too wide of a range, bro.
Between one and a billion.
Yeah.
Just like Jeff Bezos, the Amazon dude. I think his salary is like a dollar.
He's just rich, man. Huh? Let's just put rich as fuck.
98,000 a year.
Right, but he's worth because he owns so much stock.
Yeah.
That it's not even he doesn't even have that money on
cash. 98,000 a year. Yeah. Is that's what he makes. God
that's
damn.
What he banks. Yeah. So that's what he's paying on his taxes off a salary of 98,000. Which is kind of gaming the system, too, because he's the CEO, right?
Yep.
So that's basically, that's just his salary, right?
Yeah. So he's got to pay, he pays taxes on that. He ain't got to pay taxes.
That's what I mean. Like, that ain't shit compared to what he's actually worth.
Yeah.
Ain't he the first triple digit? Or he was, because his wife took half?
Yeah, I think he was.
I think
yeah.
he was the first triple digit.
Well, the first one on record. I mean, the royal family's got so much fucking hidden yeah. wealth.
Man, you
got
to be rich as fuck to just pay your
Arabians, too, dude. Like,
you
got
to be... So fucking rich just to pay your ex like it ain't shit. Like fuck it, I'm just gonna break you off.
But think about
half.
It,
just to avoid the headache. And
here's
shit.
Like the difference between like a million and a billion. Like a million
it's
seconds,
fucking huge.
Is, a million seconds is like 33 days. A billion seconds is 30 years. You know what I'm saying? Like
that's the difference.
Fucking crazy. And then so
yeah,
he's got
it's fucking
he's,
crazy.
His wife, they split 150 million, I think. So he's got 75. I mean billion. He's got $75 billion. How are you just not giving that away?
What do you do with it?
He can give everyone in America $1 million and he'd
still be rich.
He wouldn't even, he still have $74.7 billion.
Yeah, true.
Imagine that shit. If Jeff Bezos is like, here's $1 million. I won't pay taxes, but here's $1 million.
Would you want to be a billionaire, dog? I would just to be like, fuck it. Everything's just.
To have nothing matter?
You got to bust your ass to become that, though.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You got to do some evil shit. You got to
exactly.
Seriously, man, to be a CEO like that, you got to be an evil fucking
cutthroat. Yeah.
Cutthroat, like some of these employees that talk about the nightmares of just working there, dog, in the warehouse.
Yeah.
You're literally a fucking robot.
Dude,
they got machines that shock you and shit. If you move the wrong way, it shocks you.
You playing an
Did you
operation?
Hear about that?
No. Where is this?
No,
at?
They no do.
That's real.
Where?
I mean, they don't shock you like a fucking, it's like a pulse.
It's like they keep you awake.
It tells you you're going the wrong way. They got these wristbands where they scan everything. Right. Everything's. So if you move the wrong way, it buzzes you.
But what is it stopping you from doing? Making a mistake?
From making a mistake, like no, you're supposed to be aiming this way. You're not even that scanner's not even supposed to be going that way.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it says that it buzzes them. You're a fucking robot. It's these arm things. There's this like fat white kid who does this fucking. I don't know if it's a documentary, but he did this little article or video about how he was like a robot. And he was miserable working there, but he had to work like he was already getting paid decent. But like they had him, you're like a fucking robotic slave in that bitch,
I can't.
Bro.
You ever try to...
Like, just taking a break, you get in trouble for shit. Like, there's a point system.
That's fucking terrible. That's
yeah,
why
it's
I don't,
fucking crazy, dude.
I can't imagine working no
Are you
more.
Looking that shit up about the buzzing?
I can't imagine working anywhere, though. Fucking, you ever take that UPS job, like, in the wintertime?
Yeah,
when
yeah,
like,
yeah,
you
dude.
Know what? Want to make some, we
that,
need a bunch
back,
of...
That was way back in the day, man, out in fucking would, Hodgkins, I think it was.
They would ask the warehouse. You, like, all right, you want to work overnight? You would fucking work 8 hours or
just
3 days
packages.
A week. And just fucking Christmas packaging and shit, sorting shit. I was
That's
like,
wild,
man, should I do that shit? Because I was unemployed. I was like, should I do that shit? I was like, nah, I'm getting free
Did
money.
Did you find anything in there?
So I found they're saying that it's not out yet, but they have the patent for it. It's basically, so it's like, it's the vibrator on your phone, basically.
Yeah, yeah.
Like it'll vibrate your wrist and let you know where to go. But it'll also tell you, yeah, when you slack off, where your hands are in relation to the bins full of
That's
shit.
That's what I'm saying. They're already implementing them in some of the fucking warehouses.
So it's like short-range GPS radio for your hand.
Because that's
product.
How they scan shit.
That's fucking wild.
Yeah,
that's fucking
just
crazy.
Just get a robot, dude.
No, right? Yeah,
Yang Gang. Yeah. Let's give us
bag.
Yeah, well, I mean, my bad for saying shocking and shit. Like,
I'm thinking like
that's probably what it feels like. Like,
right? A motherfucker on a horse behind you, like, ah, like, oh shit, all right, like, with a cattle prod. Blah.
Where the fuck you scanning, boy? Pow, right upside the back of the head.
I'm like, oh shit, man. What the fuck's going on in fucking Amazon?
Yeah, but that's how fucking efficient they want that shit flowing, dude.
That's crazy.
But that's crazy, man.
Everything's fucked.
And that's
up.
What they're saying, that they're working, like, even an 8-hour shift, your breaks and your fucking lunches are so strict. So you're in front of that thing doing that at three hours in a row, man.
That's what you're gonna get.
3 hours straight.
That's how you get injured, like repetitive motion injury.
Yeah,
you
fucking
like
probably driving home doing that shit on your way home. Like, goddamn, you're still trying to scan shit.
You look like Dak Prescott when he was fucking walking. What is that? Like, he just fucking twitching and shit.
Hell yeah! I'd be at the grocery store scanning shit. Like, what the fuck?
He's just going
from
to work
twitching.
Mode.
Fuck yeah, he's just in work mode. Like, goddamn, I can't stop scanning shit. Man.
You go to sleep, wake up sleepwalking. You
hell yeah!
Get caught in the kitchen scanning and shit.
That shit, they turn you into a fucking robot, man.
That's crazy. And they probably pay you $15.
Like,
an
hour. What movie? There's a movie, man, where they put the fucking neck. They got these motherfuckers like in a camp. They're prisoners.
Oh yeah.
And they put these neck things around.
Well,
they
do it in Suicide Squad. I don't know that.
But this is an old school
put that
movie.
Chip in there.
Where, like, if you separate every neck fucking necklace is matched up with
isn't
another
it,
one.
It's fucking.
But you don't know who it is.
Schwarzenegger, right?
I think it is.
It's not Running Man. No.
No, it's not Running Man. It's the one where he goes to Mars.
Fuck.
Total Recall?
No, it's not Total Recall. No.
Isn't it?
Total Recall had the collar it's put not. The face on him.
That's right.
No, this one is if you separate from the one that you're matching.
Yeah.
Because you're inside of a prison barrier. Every prisoner has a neck thing, right? That explodes if you run from the prison. But it also explodes if you go a certain distance from the one that matches you. So if you're going to escape, you got to escape
Deadlock?
With the motherfucker that's with you. Is that what it's called?
There's a movie called Deadlock.
What year is it?
91.
It is that one, because they that motherfuckers has to be blowing up.
That's
man.
A B movie like a motherfucker, right?
Your head blows up. And that shit starts beeping. Motherfucker be like, oh shit. Pow,
I think I was thinking of Running Man.
Head gone. Running Man is dope too.
Yeah. Running it happens Man. At the beginning of Running Man. I'm
yeah, you know
sure,
what?
Right?
That is Running Man.
Yeah.
The one I'm
put
thinking
the
about
up his nose.
Yeah. No, it's in
it. No, that's neck. Total Recall. The one in the nose is Total Recall. Because he
there's
digs it out.
In Running Man's neck.
Yeah, it isn't. It is part. It is in the beginning of Running Man.
He gets with that guy and he's like, no,
they escape. They,
fucking,
they have to escape together.
Up,
it is Running Man.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
at the very beginning of
right,
the movie.
Right. You're
that's
right.
A stupid movie, too. Like, when you watch it now.
Dude, I fucking love that.
You got the ice dude, the big fat guy, the fucking.
I hate the fucking host of the show, or the TV show.
Richard Dawson?
Yeah. I hate the way he is and shit in the movie.
Oh, it's so good, dude. He's such a sly bag.
Dude, I love the old school special effects when it's like an explosion, but it's just straight like sparkler. Like, yes! it's not even realistic fire. It's just like that bright yellow sparkler.
Like fucking baseball game fireworks and shit.
Not like, even it's like just hit a typical room. Sparkler. Like that.
A sparkler.
You ever make a sparkler bomb?
Hell yeah.
Where you just grab a whole bunch
all
of sparklers
that shit, just put them in together?
And light it together?
Dude, the jumping jack gunpowder?
Yeah.
We used to just crack a shitload of jumping jacks and put them in a fucking jar, dog. You drop a match, you get a big-ass mushroom cloud, yo. Like,
hell yeah. That's
some
I'm,
fucked up kids, man, burning shit down, man.
We're not dead.
You ever blew up a cat, man? You ever tanked a man into a cat? You ever tie a cat to a bottle rocket?
I already have enough heat about my dog joke that I won't admit to any animal cruelty on the
just
podcast.
Just a disclaimer, I never tie no cat to no bottle rocket.
You ever tie a turtle to an M80 and see what happens?
Hell yeah.
Is this shell really good?
See that shell. See how good that shell is, man.
Motherfucker blew a chunk out of turtle. Oh shit.
Turtle ain't got to worry about no straws. This turtle need to worry about this M80.
I used to blow up my G.I. Joes, though.
Hell yeah.
I would take.
Oh, yeah, hell
I
yeah,
would
dude.
Fucking throw them up. Or I would like.
Do you remember the original G.I. Joes? You could take the screw out and you could take their fucking arms.
You put them, you mix and match.
You mix and match. Yeah, you put like fucking.
That's the one where like if you broke the dick part, the shit was useless because it was just like twisted.
Yeah, because that's what kept it in part. Yeah. In place, yeah.
So like you just twist it up like, oh damn.
That rubber band, yeah, that rubber band couldn't stick.
Yeah, once you
you put like fucking Snake Eyes head on G.I. Joe's
Storm
body and
Shadow.
Shit. Dude, them fucking toys were dope. Kids don't understand how dope
them
shit were,
I was 13
man.
Years old, bro. I ain't gonna lie.
That
like,
shit came with
G.I.
the little
Joe's.
Package, came with all the guns and the little fucking accessories.
You could
the
buy
helmet.
You could buy accessory pack.
Hell yeah, bro.
And you get the different Vipers. You had the Night
dude,
Viper, the fucking.
You never like. Because, you know, we had a lot of G.I. Joes. We used to light the motherfuckers on. We used to try to make that shit for real. Like, we played in the dirt, put some of that fucking charcoal fluid on one of the cars, light that bitch on fire.
Remember the dude that had the explosive footballs?
Oh, yeah.
I forgot what his name was. It was a football guy, and he came with little footballs. So they had like little handles on them, so he could stick in his little claw and he like pretend like he's throwing a football. I would turn that into like, I made football teams. Like I would make uniforms out of like aluminum foil and like put armor on them and shit.
And play, make
and I would
whole
play football
shit.
Games. Like
I was in Gridiron.
I think his name was Gridiron. Yeah, and he had like a little half shirt.
Captain Gridiron. Then
he had like the, he just had football.
God damn,
like,
this is old school.
Dude, I'm telling you, I love G.I. Joe. They had fucking jets and shit that you could just buy that shot missiles and shit because they had the springs in them.
Yeah, the little springs in them. Yeah, that shit was dope, man. That's why I used to collect He-Man toys too. I used to have like the fucking dude with the two heads and shit.
I had the furry one that had like the
dude with the lizard dude with the tail, Whiplash.
The one that felt like moss.
The two headed motherfucker was Too Bad. That was his name, Too Bad.
The one that felt like moss. Like it had like that weird green felt on it.
Oh, yeah, the chest and shit.
And then the fucking one with the eyes that
Skeletor.
Bugged out. Like you flip the switch in the back and
the back of the eyes pop out.
Make their eyes pop out and shit.
Skeletor.
Now I don't know what kids play with. It's all digital right now.
Nah, I don't know what the fuck.
I don't know if they actually have like action figures no more.
Motherfucker, we used to play just with dirt. You just go outside and play with dirt.
Huh?
We used to go outside and play with dirt.
I know, but I guarantee you, if we had the shit they have now, we wouldn't be complaining like, "Oh, I wish I was outside more." Like, nah, that shit was dope.
Hell no, I wish I had a fucking iPad.
Once I got a Nintendo, outside didn't exist no more.
Hell yeah, dude.
I play baseball inside. I'm good.
Yeah, but see, at the same time, man, like, I'm glad I played outside.
Oh yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, fuck that. That's what's crazy. Playing tag, like we used to play tag across the whole block.
Right.
Like, be 10 of us. You know how you have glue.
Oh yeah, you stick
whatever's
your fucking
glue
mailbox,
is it can't like, tag you. So we'll make like three glues across the block. Man, we almost get hit by cars and shit. That shit was fun, bro.
Hide and go seek. You had the block and just fucking hide them out.
Hide and go seek.
But what's crazy is like we grew up like that, and we're the generation making sure kids don't go outside because we scared. Because everyone's like, kids today have it too soft. Like, bitch, you're the one that's raising these kids and putting helmets on them.
Exactly. Right?
So
that's
it's your fault that kids today are soft. It ain't like kids just grew up that way. You making them
like
that
I
way.
Didn't raise my kids like that. They played outside. Like they spent a lot of time by their grandparents' house. They played outside. They take the bus. They know how to use the train system. They know fuck
so
that.
But the parents that are complaining like, "Oh, kids too soft." Like that's you. That's because you.
Yeah, and I know people that tell me like, "Damn, I can't believe you let your kids take the bus." Like they gotta learn. You live in Chicago, yo. You gotta learn that shit.
But like,
well, first thing I'm gonna be picking you up everywhere.
I never got fucked with taking a bus. I was 10 years old taking a bus. I never got fucked with it, man. I never did.
I mean,
I just sat there.
It just depends on where you live. Like, there was some gang shit, man.
I would get like the gangbangers, but they weren't chasing me and shit. They were just
dude. My brother and his homies used to wait on 51st and Wood because them Kings and them Stones used to take the 51st bus. And they jump on the bus and whoop people's ass, man.
Stops, they just get in, start punching motherfuckers.
Yeah, they look in the bus, but they go and they get in. They go in and fuck somebody up. Dude, this shit was on the news on 51st and Wood, where a bunch of kids jumped on. They beat the shit out of the bus driver. That shit was on the news. They just fucking started dipping on the bus driver.
I can't imagine. I hate dealing with customers. I can't imagine being a fucking
bus driver, bro.
Because you see, like, you'll get to know some people, but then some people is like, every day I got to deal with this fucker. Like, this homeless dude that gets on a bus, I got to tell him not to get on a bus.
And in the city like Chicago, even if it doesn't matter what route you have, you're going to drive through a bad area. Like,
oh, yeah.
Like, if you're taking Grand Avenue. And you gotta go west, you're gonna go through the hood.
Oh, hell yeah. Same thing with North Avenue.
You're gonna go in downtown.
North Avenue, Ashland,
you're gonna go from the hood to a nice area, back to the hood. Like, you're gonna go through some bad areas.
Cicero is always hood.
Cicero. In the west side.
Western and Cicero.
But Cicero,
always,
but once you get toward Midway Airport, it gets nicer.
Just through the airport, and then after that, it ain't.
No, like by, you know, I-55?
Yeah.
It starts to get a little nice right there. Like, Lewis lives over there.
Yeah.
It used to be grimy as fuck, but now it's. You know, there's like just family single family homes, but yeah, when you north of that, it's all the west side shit.
Dude, I saw one time I used to drive to work down Cicero, and I saw this fucking dude like at a stop sign holding his baby, and then like his mom, like the baby's mom was in the car. I'm like, damn, that's his visitation. You know what I'm saying?
That's about right.
Like, it's so weird. Like, he's got to stand in the street and just hold the talk to the, hey, how you doing? And that's him visiting his daughter.
And then he jumped back on the bus.
Right. and like the my baby mom was just in the car on her phone, like not even paying attention. I'm like, damn, that's fucked up. That's that fucked you gotta up, like man. That's the how you see your kid.
Hey man,
so
but
wear
you know,
condoms so you don't end up at a stop sign holding your fucking dog.
Hell yeah, dude. Like, that's some sad
for,
shit.
For 20 minutes, like, oh, this is my visitation. I'll see you next week. Like, what the fuck?
Dude, that's right. Like motherfuckers, you know, as a comic, too, like, people would be like, how come you never moved anywhere? Because my kids were little. Like, man, I got little ass kids. I'm not going to be no dead. Like, I would hate for my kids to hate me.
Right. Or not
like
even
right
knowing.
Now. Like, right now, even if I was a successful comic, when my kids looked at me like a piece of shit,
right.
Like, that would hurt, man. And exactly. All I got is money. To make try to make them happy, like fuck that.
Exactly,
dude.
That's why.
But now that my kids are cool and everything, like where the money at, Lord Jesus
yeah,
Christ.
Yeah, stuck around. It wasn't like you just had a baby with a fucking one off.
No, fuck
that was
that.
Their mom's. Like that was their wife. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, but you know what,
like,
man?
Hey, if you're having a kid with just like fucking one night stand, like, why are you going raw into a one night stand? Like, that's the only reason.
That's stupid as fuck.
People ask me like, because I tell people like, I like wearing condoms. They're like, why? Because if I had sex with somebody that I wasn't ready to deal with every fucking day for the next minimum 18 years,
why would you even risk?
Why would I risk it just to get a nut off? Like, I would just fucking wear the condom. It feels
no November,
it
bro.
It doesn't feel the same, but
don't
it
worry, bro. It's no nut November, man.
Huh?
It's no nut November, dog.
For the white people.
Yeah, that's right, baby.
I'm
done. Latinos are fucking
we
all the white dudes' girlfriends. Nutting all over the place. Like, like fucking Speedy Gonzalez. Like fucking.
Hey, where we
Sam.
At with time?
We're at 45.
All right, cool.
Yeah, I probably got to wrap it up.
Yeah, I was going to say, I don't want you to be late. But so, yeah, it was fucking anything coming up? Anything we missed?
No. Just...
Hey, bundle up out there, because seriously, like, I'm getting sick. People getting sick out here.
Weather change, bro. And
take some motherfucking vitamin C.
Motherfuckers getting angry outside, too.
Yeah, fucking.
Don't fuck with people, bro. Just like,
dude, man,
you don't know what kind of day somebody's having and what they got on them. So if they, like, I mean, they might not know what kind of day you having, but it ain't worth
road
it.
Road rage
to fucking
is a bitch, man.
Get into a road rage fight. Just yell in your car. Just grab the steering wheel. It's like, motherfucker. And then that's it.
Well, see, that's another thing, too. If you are going to say something, just have the window up. Look, I mean, even if you look at him like stupid motherfucker, and then just keep on going.
But you don't know what kind of day that dude's having. You're like, fuck you. Bah. Like,
say it when you're about to leave, though, when the light turns green, like, fuck you.
When he's making a left hand turn, that motherfucker's like, oh,
dude, like
fuck
the other
that.
Day on fucking 47th Street, I'm turning out of the mall where Food Flex is at. You're not supposed to go left, but everybody goes left.
But you breaking the law.
Well, hold up. Somebody else was breaking the law, too, though. When I'm making that left, a truck with some gangbangers. Like, I didn't know they were gangbangers at first. They're making a crazy-ass left turn into a one-way street, bro.
Okay.
And I didn't say nothing. Like, I wasn't like, you stupid motherfucker. I was like, it's a one-way, bro.
Right.
And they turn.
Well, they're going to go kill somebody.
Well, check this out.
They're like,
but check this out. I think they thought I was talking shit.
Oh.
So I turn on Damon. They're coming out the alley. And they see me. They come up behind me. And dudes behind me like, what's up? What's up? And I'm just in the car like, nah, nigga, I was just warning you. It was one way.
I'm doing you a service.
Yeah, like, up in the mirror, telling him, like smiling, like, nah, I was just warning you, dog. What's up, motherfucker? What's up? And I was just like, and then they turned, dude. But I was just like, God damn, they followed me all the way to 50th. I was like, I don't need this shit,
that's
right
why
now,
I don't.
Man.
That's why I don't talk to...
I would have went straight to my house, into the garage.
Yeah.
But yeah, I was just like, man, what
I just
the fuck?
I just yell at people, man. In my car, I'm like, motherfucker.
But they did go through there to look for some motherfuckers, because they weren't even supposed to be over there. Yeah.
Hell yeah.
But the shit they were throwing up at me, I was like, God damn. Tick, yeah. I would have just got out like, yo, I'm a comedian. Joey, follow me on Instagram.
How you doing? But yeah,
anything
so
coming up,
careful
man?
Out there. I just got random shows throughout the city. Oh, Carol. Well, if you're listening to this today, it's but every second Tuesday at Carol's Pub in Uptown, I got a show. I host. I bring my funniest friends.
We got a dope lineup.
And
shit,
then,
this Friday,
every third Wednesday, also a Pilsen.
Pilsen stand-up.
At Simone's, we always bring a dope lineup over there too. So.
Shit, this Friday at North Bar, we got dope comedy show.
Oh, yeah.
The homie Dave Hellum, writer for Rail, Comedy Central, all that. She's been doing this thing. That motherfucker does that show in L.A. and Chicago, flies to Chicago.
Yeah.
But now he got Dubs and Marvin Phipps hosting.
Is Dave going to be there?
I'm closing out. I don't think he's going to be on this one.
Oh, yeah. He wasn't on the last one either.
Because he's writing that job.
Yeah,
he's
writing for Raven.
Yeah, for Disney.
Disney
Raven.
Show or some shit.
All so right. Yeah, man, come check that out Friday night, man. So
Follow us on Instagram, Legal Aliens Podcast.
But yeah, check it out. We're gonna get some fucking sponsors. We're gonna do this shit.
Let's get some sponsors.
We're gonna get some sponsors, so we'll talk about all that.
Crime is not paying enough.
Crime is not paying enough.
Well, I ain't trying to go to jail, man.
Right.
That's
mean,
really Abi wants to go to prison.
I don't want to go to prison, but I'll take some stolen goods.
All right, cool. Yeah, you know, shout out to Dark Matter. I love your coffee, man. You know, wink, wink, man.
All right.
Cool, man.
That's it.
Legal Aliens Podcast. Check us out, man.
Bye.